Now, the story is moving up across the internet. Joining me, as you can see, is viral marketer Joel Veitch from RatherGood.com. Good evening to you. And we start off with Hollywood versus Twitter, and it's all over this TV show, is that
right?
Yeah,
yeah. So Twitter have announced that they've reached an agreement which is a bit vague and nebulous about a TV format. We're not sure exactly what it would be.
Well, it's difficult to describe it in 140 characters.
It is, yeah, yeah. It vaguely involves celebrity stalking in some way. The reason it's caused a problem is Ashton Kutcher has threatened to stop Twittering. Now, that might not sound like a big deal, but he's actually their number one Twitterer with 2 million followers plus, and his wife Demi Moore and their director are threatening to drop Twitter, and obviously that's causing a bit of a fracas because they're so important.
So they could be shooting themselves in the foot here,
Twitter,
couldn't they?
Could be, yeah.
Okay, we'll watch it. Facebook could be Facebooksky.
Yeah.
So?
Well, they are getting $200 million of investment from some Russians who specialise in making money out of social networks. Now, it apparently isn't going to involve any particular change of direction for Facebook, so don't expect it to suddenly turn into the Kremlin over there. But, you know, obviously they're looking to monetize what they're doing a bit more, and these guys are experts at that.
Well, they're not going to hang on to your photos, at least we know that. Who's sticking their necks out over dinosaurs?
Well, you know, okay, so sauropods, they're diplodocuses and brontosauruses. They've got the body
right,
here
and the
neck
already.
And tail. Anyway, the big ones with the
big
long
ones.
Necks.
Yeah, got that.
Yeah. Everybody thought that they had their necks lying kind of out along the ground.
Right.
Turns out that they were more like giraffes in terms of their posture. So they were 50 foot high with their heads up in the
I got taught that in school about 20 years ago.
Yeah, yeah.
They
munch
the leaves, don't they?
Yeah.
Okay, well, that's not news. why is someone suing the Guinness Book of Records?
This is the best story I've heard in a long time. This is a guy who the Guinness Book of Records are putting him in as the world's most prodigious sewer. He's sued people like the Norse gods, the Eiffel Tower.
Be careful what you say here.
Yeah.
He's a nice guy, isn't he?
Yeah, he's tried to sue Adolf Hitler, even though he's dead. And he's now suing the Guinness Book of Records for giving him the record as the world's most prodigious sewer of people.
He's a very nice bloke, really nice guy. tell us about broadband hotspots.
Yeah, so the government have recently announced plans to guarantee 2 megabits per second connectivity, which is basically fast broadband for everyone.
By 2012, isn't
it? Yeah, turns out there's 3 million homes, which is 15% of all homes, are well below that. And this is due to things like telephone exchanges not being enabled for the technology and that kind of stuff. But there's a lot of people who just aren't anywhere near that kind of internet
so
connection.
So basically, if you live, it's the same old story. If you live in a big city, you're going to be all right, aren't
you?
If you live
pretty
in the middle
much.
Of nowhere, you might not be.
Pretty much,
okay, good work. Thank you very much for explaining on those.
No,
Joel, thanks a lot.